You've just practiced with Sarah how to find the public interface of another class. Now let's go back to our car class. We had discovered the public interface that you see over here, and now our goal is to implement it. So imagine a car object, and let's have a look at the addGas method. We're adding a certain amount of gas, and what should that do to the car? Well, remember, it's not a real car, and it's not real gas. This car is just an object in a computer, and it remembers some information. In particular, in order to add gas, the car needs to remember how much gas it has. In Java, you use variables to remember anything. And here is how you write such a variable. The variable has a name, just like the variables that you've seen in the previous lesson, as well as a type. And then there is this keyword private here. That simply means that the variables of an object are a part of the private implementation. The programmer who uses the public interface doesn't need to know about them. You will always want to declare instance variables as private. Let me tell you why they're called instance variables. Let's have a look at another car object, or as we say, another instance of the car class. Of course, it also needs to remember how much gas it has, and the amount of gas that this object has will be different from the amount of gas of the other object. So each of these objects, or each of these instances of the car class, needs to have its own variable to store that information. That's what it means to be an instance variable. It's a variable that occurs in every instance of the class. Now there's another thing that each car object should remember, namely its mileage. Here is how you can define the variable. We give it a name, miles driven. Its type, it's again a number. And once again, each instance of the car class has its own value, so it needs its own copy of that variable. These are the two instance variables that we need for the car class. You will soon see how the methods of the car class update or read those instance variables. But first, go ahead and practice with Sarah how to discover the instance variables that we need for the person class.